Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with a Canvas Core Creative Crew project, and I'm going to be making a set of thank you cards. And I wanted to share with you some ideas that if you are doing something in bulk, say you were doing 10, 12, 6 or 8 or whatever, cards that are similar, very similar, some ideas to get you going so that you don't get bogged down and think, oh geez, I don't want to do this. I'm making a set for my cousin who recently had an accident, and I know she's going to have a lot of neighbors and friends and support and will need some thank you cards. I used the 8x8, these are all Gypsy Moments, which I used, this paper. I had gotten some individual sheets of paper, but I hadn't gotten this particular one. I also used a couple of the ephemera tags, the mini ephemera and just the tags from this paper line. Now, you don't have to use these. You can cut a scrap of paper. I just use those to stamp my thank you on. Then I use the Gypsy Moments Mixed Media Pad. And from the back, I took, there's always a craft sheet in the back of them. This is what I'm using for my card base because it's very sturdy, very nice construction. And I'll give you a sneak peek here. It makes a nice card base. So from this, you can get three cards, two A2, which are 4.25 by 5.5, and one 3.5 by 3.5 square card. So some of hers are going to be square, some of them are going to be A2, but they'll have the envelopes to go with them, and so it'll work out perfectly. Another thing that I used from this book, mixed media book, is the burlap. And see, this is all I have left of this peachy pink color, but it's enough to do three more cards. So this was enough to do all 9 of my cards for her. So that was great. And then the other thing, see, I've already ripped all these out, so I wanted to show you, was I used this corrugated card. It's really cool, but I didn't want white. I wanted something that would go, and can you see the beautiful color of this? And I don't know if the glimmer is going to pick up. I used Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist. This is Olive Vine, and this is the most subtle, beautiful green, and I'll show you how I incorporate that. So now, let's get started with this, so that you can see how to make a set of cards yourself. For these three cards, I'm going to be using this paper. And this has this on the back. It was really a toss-up because I love both sides of this paper, and I wasn't sure which, but this is, just speaks to me. I might even fussy cut a flower. So if any of you follow my videos, you know how much I love to fussy cut. So the first thing we want to do, and I left this so I could share it with you, is we want to cut our paper, and we want to cut it so that we're cutting at 8.5 inches so that we can have our 4.25 side. These are 12 by 12. Okay, so now we've cut our three pieces out of our 12 by 12 paper. We have enough for two A2 cards and the 3.5 inch square. We also have this little piece left and just this tiny little piece, and I'm going to toss this. And this piece I'm saving. Don't throw scraps like this away because you might be able to use them for something else. And then we're just... I'm going to use this gorgeous paper. This is called... Does this have a name? Boarding Room. Oh, isn't it just lovely? So I have three cards I'm going to do. And now what I did on my previous cards, let me show you this one, and I'll show you all when we get done, is I tore them. You can tear them by hand, or if you have a tearing ruler, this one is Creative Memories. It's the only thing I have of Creative Memories. But I know that Fiskars has a set of tearing rulers. Of our card. Isn't that gorgeous already? You could put that on it and thank you.
Well, we're going to use some of the burlap because I like the burlap
like on these cards, to show behind. So we're going to pull it. We're going to take, let's see, let's take, let's cut this piece across. I can use it for another card. And let's fold this in half because that's just about perfect. And that will give us the three cards we're making today. Now, when I say pull it, what I mean is I pull the threads out like this. So I have a fringe around the edge. And do not throw your fringe away, because this stuff is wonderful. If we don't use it on today's project, we'll be using it on another project. So tear the fringe like this until you get the desired amount of fringe around your back mat. Okay, that should probably do it. Set that aside. And we've got this. Now this is the piece we pulled off. Now until you get your fringe down, you really don't know how big you're going to want this piece. And see, it's a little bit big. My fringe isn't showing the way I want. So I'm just going to, this is the joy of when you tear it, because you don't have to worry about getting perfect. Isn't that pretty? Yes. Okay, now I also have ribbon here that I have coffee dyed, and some of it has, it was, in fact, this was tea dyed, and this was, I don't know, some kind of pink tea, and some of it got real dark, which I love. So I'm going to be tying, this is a hug snug seam binding, and I'm going to be tying this on this side. So there's our bow for the side of our card, like this. And now what I said about these strings, take five of them, and you don't want them all even, you want some longer, some shorter, you know, so they're gonna wisp at all different, five or six or whatever. Then take an extra one, like this. I'm gonna use my tweezer bees. Tie them in the middle. And this burlap, because you can see how hard I'm pulling on it, this burlap is wonderful for tying. Okay, now I'm going to take a little spot and I'm going to put it right underneath. This will glue my bow, and it will also glue my little fibers. Now see how that just makes it? Just pulls it, gives it a little bit of oomph. There we go. So let's glue the rest of this down. And I'm using just the cheap Eileen's Tacky Glue today. Someone of my our viewers was telling me they use this all the time. And I thought, you know, I have that. And I haven't used it for eons. I should get it back out and see what I think. Okay. And I'm going to put some glue on the back here. Now see how fast this is? This takes no time at all, but this is really pretty. Look at here. Now we just need a little tag and a thank you. Now you can use this card either direction. And because of the inside sentiment that I just found, I'm going to use this old Stampin' Up one. It says, kindness comes in many forms, but always from the heart. I'm going to use that for the inside. And then I have the Spellbinders one, Celebrations one, and it just has a really pretty script thank you on it. So what I did is I just went through all of my, I have all my stamps in a book, a binder, and I just went through the binder and picked out the stamps that I liked and had them sitting here so I could make a choice of what I wanted to. I used on these, because look how gorgeous that is, I had this old Prima ink, and I have no idea because I only have two of these Prima inks. This is called Pastel Brown. I don't think I've ever used it, but it was the perfect color. And the other one that I found that works so well is the Tim Holtz Distress Ink in Tattered Rose. This is great for this. I have these two tags from this set just the tag set. These are quite small, but you can see they certainly aren't quite right, but we can change them up. We can, and I don't know which one I'm going to use yet. I'm going to start with this one and see if it gives me, I don't think it's going to give me enough of the pink look. And I'm going to do the back side too in case it flips at all. See if our stamp will fit on there. Yes, perfectly. I'm going to use some of the Tim Holtz. Do this. Grab any tag, grab a little piece of paper, whatever. But I have these, so I wanted to use them. What I'm saying is, if you're going to do 10 or 12 of them, make it as simple as possible for yourself. But I love this tag, and it's going to go perfect on there. So it depends on how much time and involvement you want to spend on your cards. And I'm just going to do this one in black because I want to make sure that this thank you shows up, and I'm putting it toward the bottom. Oh, perfect. Isn't that gorgeous script? And now I think I'm going to tie it on with a couple of these burlap. And that's the front of our card is finished. Now, even with taking the time to ink that, it still was no time at all. So let's finish the inside. I'm going to take an 8x8 sheet. It's the same identical sheet as that one, but this is a little bit lighter. And this is what I'm going to use for my okay, this is what I've stamped on just a piece of the torn lighter weight paper. And I'm going to put it in the middle this way. This still gives room to put a note below it or to write a note above it. What a pretty card. Okay. Let's do another. Thank you. Okay, before I go, I wanted to show you about the envelopes. I use the We Are Memory Keepers 1-2-3 punch board. If you have a scoreboard with an envelope maker, you can use it, or you can Google online to see how to just cut them yourself. But homemade envelopes are so nice. But if you don't want to do that, just purchase some or look through your stash and see what you might have. For my envelopes, I use Georgia Pacific cardstock. I get this at Walmart. It's 110 pounds, and you get 150 sheets in it, and I think it's like, I don't know, $5. Super cheap. And then I use the Tattered Rose Distress Ink, and this is what they look like. This is how they turn out. They're very simple. Here's just the envelopes, and I have the two sizes. And now, here's the cards that we made on camera today. This one with the thank you. And you can go back and add more and more to them, depending on what you want. But these are quick. Now, granted, I fussy cut the flower and the leaf out and made it more involved. But if you know me, I just couldn't throw that. And I cut the other one out for the front. So this one does take more time. But you don't need to do that. You have enough examples here to show you how to make them without going to all the involved. And when you send them, you still have this beautiful array of cards. So there's the three I made on camera today. Here are the others that I've made. Same principle, a little bit different paper. And here's the inside, another stamp. And I just love this tone on tone. There's that one. Here's another little one. But see, they're really quick. They basically have three layers and one layer on the inside. And so that's a pretty quick way to do them. This one I did add a butterfly. I just snipped it out of two layers of the paper. And this was a scrap of the top. You can see where this was bound into the mixed media book that I bought, the paper pad. This was the very top part, and I just put here's another one of the papers from the from this. Let me see if I can find it to show you which one it is. Of course, I'm not going to be able to now. I can't find it now. But there's that one. So there's another one. Here's another one. I added a little strip of lace. I just had this tiny little piece and some flowers. And this one pops down. This is another one of the tags. And it says, thank you so much here. And then it just tucks under the ribbon. And then for the inside. Very, very simple. And here's the last one with this, the seam binding. But basically, 1, 2, 3 layers is all you've got. And three layers on the inside. Very, very simple and easy. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I should have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I guess I made 8 cards instead of 9. But it's still a great set. And you can see how great they pop into the envelopes. And this paper is sturdy enough that if she were going to mail them, I think they could go through the mail. They would require probably extra postage, but you wouldn't have a problem with them scrunching in the mail. So there you are. Try out your own set of homemade greeting cards. Thank you cards, sympathy cards, what birthday cards, whatever you need. But this is going to make a great gift for my cousin now. Thanks, everyone. Thank you for joining me. Check out Canvas Course. And also, if you aren't a subscriber, I hope you subscribe, like, and comment today. Have a great crafty day, everyone. Bye-bye.